Greetings, fellow RotoBallers. It is time. And look, this means week 17. You've made it to the fantasy finals, or maybe you're just trying to win your money back. So let's go to our RotoBaller rankings and get locked in for our biggest movers and shakers in that week 17. Dave, at quarterback, we have our normal top three: Josh Allen, Patrick Mahomes, Justin Fields. Wait, what? Did I read that right?
Yeah, you said Justin Fields, Joey. And he's ranked QB2.
So what?
I feel like we willed this, Joey. You and I. We did this.
We pushed him up the mountain. Our boy is growing so fast. Flight JF1, he has made it. And if he plays, now look, that's a big if. He's a little banged up right now, and we're taping this on a Tuesday. But if he does, he's a smash versus the Lions. And Dave, on the other side of the ball, Jared Goff up to his highest ranking of the year at QB6. I wonder why. Could it be because he's playing the Chicago Bears defense?
Probably.
That's probably it. Yes.
Our biggest baller, though, Joe, Geno Smith, who became a staple of the top 12, now finds himself the odd man out looking in. QB13 this week. Now onto the dumpster fire that is tight end, where behind Kelsey, it's been a battle all year to lock up that number two spot, but it looks like it's TJ Hawkinson. With back-to-back good games, he's our tight end two. Dallas Goedert right behind him as our tight end three.
And Dave, look, don't look too far. Mark Andrews, he didn't fall that far off. He's tight end five, because if Lamar plays this week, we think that he can morph back into the player that he was in the beginning of the season. Then we have at tight end nine, a running back is listed. Wow, that seems odd. Oh, that's why. It's because it's Taysom Hill. Taysom Hill. This must be some sort of mistake. This is tight end play in 2022. Taysom Hill is your tight end nine. Whew. Let's move over to wide receivers. Dave, we're CeeDee Lamb. He's on an absolute heater right now. He's our wide receiver six this week. And our boy, Garrett Wilson, back up in the charts. Wide receiver 12 with Mike White probably scheduled to come back and play this week.
I love that white guy. Now, both the Dolphins and the Bengals wide receiver cores inside our top 12. But the Bucks wide receiver cores, Joey, they're falling. Mike, Big Mike, wide receiver 17. Chris Godwin, wide receiver 14. Think those avocado milkshakes aren't working for old Tom Brady anymore, Joe.
Yes, Dave. Avocado, the 32nd flavor of Baskin-Robbins that is rightfully forgotten.
Yes. Joey, I'm just surprised Brady has a voice at this point. He's been doing a lot of yelling on the sidelines.
A lot of falsetto, a lot of baritone. He's really running the range. And Dave, speaking of yelling, I bet that's what fantasy managers did a ton last week if they had drafted Austin Eckler, one of the few studs who continues to deliver. Therefore, he's the RB1 heading into this week. Saquon is RB3. You love to see that. And James Conner, he's got his highest ranking of the year as RB5. But Dave, there were some huge biggers. There's some huge big fallers this week, wasn't there?
Yeah, absolutely, Joey. Much like his quarterback, Ken Walker also finds himself on the outskirts of the top 12. RB13 this week. And guys like Tony Pollard, Aaron Jones, Alvin Kamara, all outside the top 12. But a name to watch, Joe, Cam Akers.
Do I have to watch?
RB18, yes, in our rankings. Would you believe me if I told you? He's RB4 over the last 4 weeks. I feel like this is his time of year every year. No other time of year, but December, Cam Akers leads people to this. Okay.
He's going to do it. It's the season. He is alive, Dave. Yeah. Definitely squeeze Cam Akers in the same way that I squeeze into my jeans this weekend after demolishing all the tray of leftover Christmas cookies. But I digress, Dave. I think it's time. It's our 60-second risers and fallers recap coming at you right now. Now, it's the Fantasy Finals, RotoBallers, so here are the biggest risers and fallers in our rankings for Week 17. If JF1 plays, there's one quarterback we like more. He's QB2 on the week, and his opponent, Jared Goff, QB6, and Geno Smith falling to QB13.
Yeah, tight end Hawkinson and Dallas Goedert round out the top three tight ends. But if you're desperate, Taysom Hill is still locked in as a top 10 tight end. He's tight end 9. Now we move over to wide receiver, where CeeDee Lamb has shot all the way up to wide receiver 6. Our boy Garrett Wilson is back in our good graces with Mike White starting again. He's our wide receiver 12.
Gotta love the return of White Lotus on that one. We end with running backs, where Saquon makes the top three, and we think James Conner stays hot this week. He's an RB5, but big falls from grace. Ken Walker, Aaron Jones, Tony Pollard, even Alvin Kamara, all outside the top 12 this week. Now like, subscribe, lock in those lineups, and go win that trophy.
Yes.
It's yours. Go get it.
Go get it, folks. We've had a fun season. We want to thank all of you guys for watching. Make sure you subscribe to the RotoBaller channel. Make sure you're following us on TikTok at RotoBallerNFL. I'm going to be doing content fantasy football-wise year-round, the whole offseason. No breaks.
What's up, Carl? Thanks, Sean.
All right.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, guys.